Heads up, commuters. The LRT Lines 1 and 2 will implement a fare hike for the first time in 8 years. Starting August 2, the minimum boarding fare in both railways will be up 13.25 pesos from 11 pesos, with an additional 21 centavos for every kilometer traveled. President Marcos approved the fare hike during a cabinet meeting June 6, citing the falling inflation and unemployment rates. The Transport Department says a fare increase will fund maintenance and other operating expenses.
To illustrate, the current end-to-end fare of the LRT Line 2 is at 30 pesos. Now, with the approved fare adjustment, the new end-to-end fare would now be at 35 pesos. It is important to note that the actual fare per passenger on an end-to-end trip is at 178 pesos. This is at break even, no profit. With a fare adjustment from 30 pesos to 35 pesos, the national government will still have to subsidize 143 pesos per passenger per ride.
Philippine Health Secretary Ted Herbosa considers giving temporary licenses to nurses who fell a few points short in the nursing board exams. This is in a bid to fill thousands of nursing positions in the government. Herbosa said he wants to offer the temporary licenses to exam takers who scored 70 to 74% on the test.
So ilang porsyento pa doon yung 70 to 74? Mas masakit pa siguro yung 74.5, di ba? Kasi technically may alam yon. Kasi nasagot niya yung 70% ng tanong sa board exam. So ang gagawin ko lang, i-hire ko siya. Actually, nag-agree na si Secretary Laguesma sa idea ko. At kakausapin niya raw ang PRC para mabigyan ng temporary license itong kategorya ng nurses na to.
Herbosa made the remarks on the sidelines of the Health Department's turnover event. Former DOH officer in charge, Maria Rosario Vergere, officially turned over the department's helm to Herbosa on Monday. Vergere said she's glad Herbosa's plans are aligned with the principles of universal health care that the Health Department earlier set out to pursue.
I think all is aligned. Gusto ko lang sabihin na nagpapasalamat tayo kay Secretary Ted Herbosa kasi hindi siya nag-veer away from the direction na ginagawa natin nung naumpisahan natin nung ako ay OIC.
Other news, Philippine Marine Corps renders honors to former Senator and AFP Chief of Staff Rodolfo Biazon in Fort Bonifacio, Taguig City. Our correspondent Bianca Dava now on the line for more. Bianca?
Hi, Ron. For the Philippine Marine Corps, the late soldier and statesman Rodolfo Bongbong Biazon has returned home. On Monday, the remains of the former senator, congressman, and chief of staff of the Armed Forces of the Philippines were brought to the Philippine Marine Corps headquarters here in Fort Bonifacio, Taguig City, where he was given full military honors. Aside from becoming the chief of the AFP, Biazon was also the commandant of the Philippine Marines from 1987 to 1989. In fact, he is the only Marine general to be named as AFP chief so far. According to the Philippine Marine Corps Commandant Major General Arturo Rojas, Biazon was one of the reasons why he joined the Philippine Marines. At that time, Rojas was still a cadet and Biazon was a colonel coming out from a Marine Brigade deployment in Davao. Even after he retired from the service, Biazon remained active in the activities of the Philippine Marines. In fact, he even attended Rojas's assumption of command in May this year. During earlier full military honors, Marine officers and personnel lined up to conduct the manning of the rail and rendered salute to the late senator and AFP chief. The remains of Biazon were then transferred here to the Holy Child Chapel inside the Marine headquarters. Veteran and active soldiers paid their last respects to Biazon. Among those who arrived here earlier are AFP Chief Andres Centino, Philippine Navy Flag Officer in Command Toribio Adasi Jr., and Philippine Army Commanding General Romeo Browner Jr. A mass and mythological service will be held here this evening. Ron, tomorrow, Biazon will be laid to rest at the Libingan ng Mga Bayani at 11 a.m. following a mass at 8 p.m. Reporting from Taguig City, Bianca Dava, ABS-CBN.
Thanks for the story, Bianca.